playfulness. And I looked into all the different things that Pamela came up with. Playfulness is not there. It's surprising. It's an adventure is observing, listening, perspective. There's no play. So maybe there is no play in curiosity. Well, it's amazing that it's not in there. Mystery there, wondering, exploring. What came to mind is playfulness. I thought for sure it's got to be there. And it's not. I get it. You know, if you're with a client, then maybe it's implied you shouldn't play. You should work. You know, what comes to mind is Walt Disney and some of you obviously know about the format that he with storyboarding. And of course you have the dreamer, you have the critic and the realist. And of course there's a fourth component, which is the observer. But in the dreaming state, he refused to have any critics there. He just said, get out of the room, or at least get your mind out of the room. And when he was doing the dreamer perspective, he became, if he was doing a storyboarding on Pluto or Mickey Mouse, he actually took the demeanors of those characters and became real playful. So just interesting part. And you put yourself in an observer position, observing somebody else's experience and their curiosity. And if you look at that, that's exactly what curiosity is. You become an observer, not being in the first person or second person, but the third person, looking objectively at the situation, because all of a sudden your feelings and emotions are taken away and you're able to just be present. Phases, actually three phases. You have the coach, you have the client, and you have the observer position. And we spoke about how to get into that curiosity position. And maybe that curiosity position is being an observer. For me, it's getting into playful mode and preparing. The other part is someone else asked about how to get the client in a curious moment. And one of those that really works well is if you've asked them to step into the future. And it happened to me this past week, and I was in a situation where somebody had a traumatic situation, and then he said, well, 10 years from now, looking back, this will be a defining moment, and it would be something that was very positive out of a negative situation. So it's interesting that if you ask your client to not only invite them to be curious, but if, you know, sometimes they don't want to be curious, but if you ask them to step into the future, either a year, 5 years, or 10 years from now, and then look back at this situation, which now it's an observer position. It's actually a future position. Look back at the present. Now they can't help but be in an observer position and almost curious and hopefully playful. But I think that's a very interesting state to get your client into. So let me put it more specifically. When was the last time you were curious about a movie that was coming out? And what did they put out? A trailer, right? And a trailer is a teaser. And so if you want to have other people be curious about something, become a teaser. What's an example of teasers? And teasers is anything like you just mentioned, is being able to put yourself out there and follow the trailer, follow the path. And one of those things that is really cool to do is improv. Improv sessions, I've been to them. They're really a lot of fun. You know, you get into a really fun state, and the improv is somebody gives you a topic and you take it and you run with it. It's like a teaser type of thing. And I think in the business world, we can send out teasers. We can put out blogs. We can put out speeches. We can make ourselves known. Those are teasers, I think, in the business world. And of course, a teaser might be also with a client. When we're with a client, the invitation to connect, the invitation to have a meeting, or upcoming next, in our next session, we want to cover this and draw up a path. Where are we heading? Upcoming next is going to be these kind of things. And I want you, when you come to the session, I want you to be happy, content, full of curiosity, but let's accomplish something. So I think that sets up the session going forward. And hopefully that gives some brainstorm or rainstorm. Yeah, I fully agree with that. But here's the prelude to happiness or playfulness. And then there's a prelude to that. Here's the point. You don't have to be curious all the time. No, you can be if you want to, but it's, you got to have room for all the other emotions. But you must, as a coach, be curious, playful before you meet your client. because you're the leader going in. So it's a state. So what I do 5 or 10 minutes before I come with the client or important event, I get in a playful mood and I start to laugh. Laughing is one of those things that I force myself to do. It doesn't come naturally. It's just one of those things that it's an exercise. Do 10 sit-ups, 10 push-ups, and 10 laughs. Actually, what I do on a daily basis, most of the time, is I run down the stairs laughing. And there's a ho-hee-ha component to it. So, I mean, this is a science. This is not for the weak of heart. This is for the true martial artist. So running down the stairs, because it's easier. I tried laughing, running up the stairs, doesn't work. Go down the stairs. But the point about this is 5 or 10 minutes before you're with a client, get in that state before your client is all the time. Not just sometimes, all the time.